Hey, folks, that's enough. Thank you. Those are my middle school children in the back. Let's not act like middle school children tonight. Come on, keep it together, please. All right, so this next piece that we're going to sing tonight is a piece called Ovos Omnes. It's in Latin. I wanted to read you the text before we sang it, and also mention that this particular piece is written by a guy named Blake Henson. Blake Henson and I went to college together back on the East Coast, and I'm pretty sure that when we sang this a few weeks back, it was the Washington State premiere of this particular piece. It has been one of our favorites for sure this year. It's an absolutely stunning piece of music. The translation is... O all you who walk by on the road, pay attention and see if there be any sorrow like my sorrow.
Thank you. first of all, just to give you a little bit of an idea of what that particular text means, I didn't want to read it beforehand because I thought it was going to give it away. That day of wrath, that dreadful day, shall heaven and earth in ashes lay. As David and the Sibyl say, what horror must invade the mind when the approaching judge shall find and sift the deeds of all mankind. Call to me with the blessed, save me, fount of pity. It's like, I love it when classical music is hardcore. It's so much fun. All right, so I have a little bit of talking to do, and I'm going to try to make this as quick as and painless as I possibly can. Being our final concert of the year, we always take the time to honor our seniors who are graduating. And this has been a really special group of seniors, and I'm going to invite all of them to come down right now. So come on down, seniors, and then I'm gonna embarrass you. It's gonna be great. And I promise I'll be quick. If you can, please wait until the end of everybody so that we can get all the applause together at the same time. So first up is Andrea, and I'm just gonna tell you a little bit about people, and where are you, Andrea? You're right in front of me. So Andrea is hoping to become an actress someday, which is a pretty awesome thing to want to be. Her favorite memory from choir has been making friends, and she will miss singing the most, which is, I think, a pretty good thing to be missing. And her advice to those people that are either still in choir or are thinking about being in choir is be yourself. Don't be afraid or hide yourself from others, and I think that that's pretty awesome advice. So thank you so much, Andrea. No, don't clap yet. Don't clap yet. It's okay. You're fine. Okay, I'm going to put this over here so I'm not awkwardly holding this. Alexis, Miss Alexis over here, is going to be going over to Clark College next year to study internet security, which is pretty cool, cybersecurity. And her favorite memory was being able to sing with all of you. So I think that that's a pretty important, special thing. It's been a very funny clash, she says, and I take full responsibility for that. And she says, if you have a voice and sing, just join choir, which, again, awesome advice. Thank you, Alexis. Sophia, where are you? There's Sophia. Sophia, next year, is going to be going to Northern Arizona University. And I looked up FNP, is that family nurse practitioner? Yes, wants to be a family nurse practitioner eventually, which is pretty awesome. One of her favorite memories of choir is meeting Penelope. That is one thing that's really special in choir, is that we get really close to people. So that was her favorite thing. And has really enjoyed being able to bond with people over very niche things, very specialty things, and being able to explore my voice in a safe space with instruction. So that is Sophia, and that is for you, Sophia. All right, next up, I've got Ariel. Ariel, if you haven't already noticed, is like slays when it comes to the hair, and is hoping to go to cosmetology school and do dyeing and cutting and all that kind of stuff. She has been able to meet so many new people with common interests, and learning new music and weird music from Mr. Boughton. Woo! And some of the advice that the students put forth as things that they would say puts it far better than I ever could. They say, no one cares as much as you think they do, just sing. And I could not agree with that more. So thank you for that pearl of wisdom. Aaron Narvasa over here. All right, Aaron is has no idea what she wants to do next year. And you know what? Sometimes I feel the same way, so it's all right. Her favorite part of this class has been having this particular class with both of her siblings. So three of them in one class, which has been a pretty awesome treat for me as well. She will miss the fun conversations and singing in different languages. And her advice is, be confident and sing out. Don't hide your voice. Mr. Boughton can help you more if he can hear you. And yes, I can. Thank you, Aaron. Jasmine Nunez. So Jasmine's got all kinds of stuff going on. She is going to be starting to work at a child care center, right? And is going to be starting at WSUV in the fall, while also working and taking her paraeducator certification so that she can become a paraeducator, and then eventually, I completely agree, and then become an English teacher. English, yes? English teacher, which I'm really excited she'll do incredibly well with that. Favorite memory is being able to embrace herself and finding new friendships without a lot of effort, just because everybody vibed together. Having the opportunity to be with those people has been an honor. She's gonna miss the most the environment and all of these lovely humans. She's done this for so long, it's going to be extremely different now that those 9 years in choir are done. And her advice is enjoy your time with your people and this class. It has brought insane amounts of joy to me and my life, and I hope that all of you enjoy it and take care of each other as well. Thank you. Maya, Rich, where are you? Maya has taken as many classes with me in the last 2 years as is possible, four of them in the last 2 years. She is excited to be a screenwriter and director someday and writes incredibly well. Loved playing Cahoots and other games together. I loved this miss most, is Mr. Boughton singing my name when I walk into the classroom. This is something I do to a lot of students, and it's a lot of fun. And singing with everybody and having important conversations, which I think has been a really important part of our class as well. Great advice. Everybody is singing, don't worry. Voice cracks are normal. Let your voice do voice things. Which is great. Let it do voice things. I couldn't put it better. Thank you. Isabel is going to save and work hard towards future goals. Favorite memory is junior year honor choir. Having a group of kids all my age singing that beautifully made me realize I have no idea what I was capable of. Missing the most is running the Instagram page. Yeah, I definitely don't do that. I'm so bad. She yells at me all the time for posting stupid things. And hearing the group improving all the time. Working together to develop new traditions and events, which I'm excited to take forward. And she also says, advocate for yourself. Let yourself be vulnerable, which, amen. Thank you. And then don't forget, I'm going to give you all a flower, too, just so you know. I forgot that part, but it's okay. It's right there. And certainly last but not least is Kyle. Kyle is going to be going to join the Marine Corps. He's already started some of his training. Hoorah. And then is going to be going on to PSU to study architecture. His favorite memory is the laughter and the excellent piano playing. I assume that's from you, not from me. And all of the beautiful sound. the thing he's going to miss the most is the connected singing and the whole warm-up. And his advice is understand that this class was made for singing and music. So try and you will receive. And I just wanted to point out, too, with Kyle, he's actually taking this class for no credit and shows up every day because he wants to. And I think that that's, that says a lot about who he is as a person. So so to him and to all of our seniors this year, thank you so much. One of the last things I'll say this evening, we have been unbelievably blessed this year to have Anna Grishevsky here playing with us. Our program is absolutely stronger because of her. She's going to be attending Central Washington University next year for choral education studies / voice / piano / all of the things, something like that. And I have flowers for you, they're backstage. I'll grab them for you afterwards, it'll be great. This particular piece is a piece that I'm so excited to present to you this year. It is a piece that's been sung a lot around the country by high school choirs and middle school choirs. It is called Ad Astra. It is the state motto of Kansas, and it's basically to the stars through struggle. And this one's fun and features Anna over here on the piano. So enjoy Ad Astra.
Ad Astra, Ad Astra, Ad Astra, Ad Astra.
down for our last piece. Seniors, come on down. Folks, just notice if they're behind you. I do also want to just say a huge thank you to my eighth graders this year from Geyser. Eighth graders, raise your hands. There's a lot of them. They're not raising their hands very high. This particular group of eighth graders... a lot of them... Raise your hand if you were in choir at Geyser for all 3 years. Yeah, and remember what 3 years ago was like? We started choir online, which is not a thing. And then when we were back in person, children had to be 9 feet away from each other. And so I could get six of them into my room. And I have a large choir room, six of them. And it was just, the fact that they stayed with it means so much to me because it was not an easy 3 years. And they have persevered and they have come so far, and I'm super, super proud of them and hope that all of them will continue to sing in high school as well. Yeah, so for the eighth graders. Turn around. An old Irish blessing. Applause for all of these kids and for Miss Anna Gruszewski and for Avelina out there. We are going to do our first major transition to the orchestra. Thank you all so much for being here tonight. We'll be as quick as we can. Here we go.
While they're setting up for our first song, I just want to take a moment to say how very, very proud I am of the Fort Orchestra. This year, we went to Oaks Park and played Musics in the Park, and we won first place, which was awesome. And also won best in our division. So we got two trophies to take home. That was really exciting for us. A lot of fun. The first piece we're going to play is called Dust in the Wind. It's an oldie but a goodie by the band Kansas. If you haven't heard it, if you're thinking, I don't know what that is, you'll probably recognize it once you hear it. Gavin Alanese is going to be joining us on the double bass, or not the double bass, the electric bass, excuse me. And our very own violinist, Jessica Capps, is going to be playing the guitar solo.
Thank you.
our next piece is from one of my most favorite musicals, Hamilton. It's called My Shot. I had the opportunity to actually go and see it last fall, which was awesome. And I also know somebody that can sing it. So our Fort Vancouver High School's very own Mr. Benjamin Boughton will be joining us.
I am not throwing away my shot. Hey, yo, I'm not throwing away my shot. Hey, yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. I'ma get a scholarship to King's College. I probably shouldn't brag, but dag, I made it an astonish. The problem is I got a lot of brains, but no polish. I got a struggle dog to be heard with every word I drop knowledge. I'm a diamond in a rough. I shine a piece of coal, trying to reach my goal. My power of speech, unimpeachable. Only 19, but my mind is older. These New York City streets get colder. I shoulder every burden, every disadvantage. I have learned to manage. I don't have a gun to brandish. I walk these streets famished. The plan is to fan this spark into a flame. But dag, it's getting dark, so let me spell out the name. I am not throwing away my shot. Hey, no, I'm not throwing away my shot. Hey, yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. But dang, it's getting dark, so let me spell out the name. I am the A-L-E-X-A-N-D. We are bent to be a colony that runs independently. Meanwhile, Britain keeps spitting on us endlessly. Essentially, they tax us relentlessly. The King George turns around, run to spends his free. He ain't ever gonna set his descendants free. And there will be a revolution in this century. And I am not throwing away my shot. And yo, I'm not throwing away my shot. And yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. Let him hear him go. Shout it from the rooftops. Hey, from the rooftops. Come on, come on, let's go. Rise up when you're living on your knees. You rise up. Tell your brother that he's gotta rise up. Tell your sister that she's gotta rise up. When are these colonies gonna rise up? 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 Rise up. I'm past patiently waiting. I'm passionately smashing every expectation. Every action's an act of creation. Time I'm thinking about tomorrow, and I'm thinking about tomorrow. And I am not throwing away my shot. Hey yo, I'm not throwing away my shot. Hey yo, I'm just like my country. I'm young, scrappy, and hungry, and I'm not throwing away my shot. We're gonna rise up. It's time to take a shot. We're gonna rise up. It's time to take a shot. We're gonna. It's time to take a shot. It's time to take a shot. Take a shot, shot, shot. And yo, it's time to take a shot, time to take a shot. And I am not throwing away my, not throwing away my shot.
Thank you, Mr. Boughton. This is the part where I get to talk about my seniors and cry. Okay, I have four seniors this year. They have all been with me since middle school. Let's start with Melanie. Actually, go ahead and come on up, guys. All four of you. Yeah. Wrong way. That's awesome. So anytime anybody's on their phone during class, I ask them, what kind of pizza are you ordering me? I finally got one, you guys. I finally got it. Thank you. All right, Melanie plans to go to WSU and hopes to become an immigration lawyer. Her favorite memory is how excited she was when she first started playing. And what she will miss most about being in orchestra is hearing the music we played and Mrs. Johnston. And some advice she'd give to incoming freshmen to the orchestra next year, make the most of the time and use your time wisely. Next is Adriana. Adriana plans to attend Washington State University, Vancouver, and major in nursing. Her favorite memory or experience from orchestra is sitting next to my best friend, Melanie, all 6 years we've been in orchestra together. They've been stand partners. And what she will miss most about being in orchestra is getting new pieces and then learning them and feeling accomplished. And Mrs. Johnston. Some advice she'd give to incoming freshmen: enjoy the sound you are creating while playing. Don't annoy Mrs. Johnston. And practice, because I didn't. Avelina. Avelina plans to go to college for AA and probably pursue music and teach private lessons, which she should do. Her favorite memory or experience from playing with the orchestra is playing together with the band and the field trips. And what she'll miss most is playing with friends, having opportunities like LCR-MEA, solo ensemble, honors orchestra, and clinics. And her advice is practice, practice, practice. No matter what, scales will save your life. That's very true. And last but not least, we have James. James is going to BYU Idaho and hopefully play heart songs in orchestra. And his favorite memory or experience from orchestra is Oaks Park. Very fun. What will he miss most about being in this orchestra? He said, being the absolute best and carrying everyone. His advice is, it takes up like half the page, so I'm just going to read a couple of them. Play loud, strive to be better, have fun. I also, before, go ahead and give these guys a round. I also have an award that I give out every year. I don't have the plaque with me, but I give out an Outstanding Orchestra Musician Award every year, and that person is James Field. He always strives to do better. He's always on time. He's always there. He's shown great leadership qualities, and his detail to attention is awesome, and I very much appreciate that. So thank you, James. All right, we have what? Go ahead. You guys can go ahead. Now I don't have to get dinner. This is awesome. We have one last piece for you. We've had a lot of fun with this piece. It's called Jazz Rhythmico. Thank you. Thank you very much for being here and supporting your kids in music. We're going to hand it over to the band. We'll take just a moment to transition.
Test? Oh, thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Keith Norris. I'm the director of the Fort Vancouver High School Concert Band. This is the Fort Vancouver High School Concert Band. Since March, we have been working on, you want to call it a curriculum package, a curriculum unit on playing jazz styles. And I selected three pieces for us to do. And you're all saying to yourself, woohoo, three pieces. Good, this is going to be over soon. But they're all medleys, so each piece is like 10 tunes. So we're actually going to play 30 tunes for you. But, sorry. So we'll be playing a Brazilian samba, jazz samba, that was written by the great jazz saxophonist Sonny Rollins. And that will be, I'll tell you the rest later. Let's just start with this piece entitled St. Thomas by Sonny Rollins.
Thank you.
So that was a modern piece, that modern Latin jazz written, that piece was probably written in the 60s or 70s. Going backwards, we worked a lot on swing styling, music from the 30s and 40s, the World War II era. And one of the most popular big band composers or big band leaders of the World War II era, you might have heard the name before, his name was Glenn Miller. And he had so many top 40 hits on the radio. So what can I say? So we're going to play a medley of Glenn Miller hits for you now, featuring songs, I don't know if the titles mean anything, In the Mood, String of Pearls, Little Brown Jug, Tuxedo Junction, was made popular by the Manhattan Transfer in the 1970s, and the last one is called Pennsylvania 65,000. And if you don't know the tune or know the context of this tune, I'll give you as quickly as I can the context of a strange tune entitled Pennsylvania 65,000. In 1917 or 18, the world's biggest hotel opened in New York City. It was entitled the Hotel Pennsylvania, and it was right across the street from the busiest train station in the United States, Pennsylvania Station. This hotel had several ballrooms, several dining rooms, coffee shops, meeting rooms, and 6,000 rooms. 6,000 rooms in this 10 or 11 story hotel. They just tore it down about 2 months ago. It took them years to tear it down. The hotel was so big that it had its own telephone exchange. It had its own number, like, you know, here in Vancouver, at least at Vancouver Public Schools, everything is 313-4000 or 313-3000, whatever, depending on what school you want to call. And in the old days, you didn't just say 313, but you actually had a word that helped you memorize. So, you know, you'd hear advertisements back in the 1960s, you could hear advertisements where they'd say, call Oxford 73287, that's Oxford 73287. Or they might say, Klondike 51000. Pennsylvania 65000 was the name of the phone number that would get you to the front desk of this massive hotel where I'm sure the Glenn Miller Band played on a regular basis in Manhattan. So here we are with our medley of Glenn Miller tunes. It features all kinds of great sound effect gags that were very popular in the 30s and 40s. So you'll hear a lot of the brass players doing a lot of work with toilet plunger mutes over their bells and also other mutes and all kinds of smears and other effects. So we hope you'll enjoy Glenn Miller in concert. Thank you. I have just a few few speakers that I'd like to senior about. Quicker. Thank you. Thanks. So the first senior I'd like to recognize tonight is Tegan Wells. She came to... She came to us from Discovery Middle School. She's been with us for 4 years. She played, in her time here, she played clarinet for years and then moved to bass clarinet. And from bass clarinet, she finished off with tenor saxophone. So she's made it around the band in a good way. She plans to go to Clark College to complete prerequisites and then finish them by transferring to, says WSU Spokane, is that right? Interesting, okay. I did not know there was one there. Okay, her favorite memory or experience from band is going to the Oregon Symphony. We go every other year to go see the movie music of John Williams performed. So she's been to that at least once. What she'll miss about band is she'll miss performing for others. And some advice she has for incoming freshmen is learn how to count. Yes, in the music too, not just for, you know, at the grocery store. Okay, so that is Ms. Tegan Wells. The next student in line here is Sergio Tovar, who came over to us from Disco too, so it's convenient. So they both came together as a package. Sergio has been, he's been clarinet, first clarinet for a couple years. And he was also our drum major this year, did a fabulous job. He didn't think he was ready for it, but by the end he was very ready for it. And Sergio proved himself to be a real trooper in that in our first parade in the rain over at the fort, the historic reserve, I don't even think we had started marching yet when he tapped me on the shoulder and he said, the marching shoes that you gave me here from fort, the soles have ripped off. So Sergio marched in the rain in his socks for, I don't know, 2 mile parade. So he's got spirit, right? They call that. They call that grit in the high schools. Okay. Sergio plans to go to Clark College part-time in their nursing program while also working part-time. He plans to continue band for at least a while into the future. He loves, his favorite memory is walking around Long Beach during the Loyalty Days event for 2 hours or more trying to find water in a box. Yeah. Is it the same though? What he'll miss most about band is he's going to miss talking with me after class about band related topics and then being late for his next class. So I hope you're not out here. Okay, and his advice for incoming freshmen is to know your fingering for your instrument. In other words, yeah, know your notes. Don't do like Sergio did in his freshman year, flipping to the back of the book to find out what buttons you're supposed to be pushing. That'll save time. Okay. And I also want to say that I have a special band director's award that I award each year. And this year's recipient for that award goes to Sergio Tovar. Maritza came to us from Jason Lee Middle School. She, at the time she arrived, she was playing clarinet in my band, and she was also playing violin and orchestra. And then her schedule, I guess, got a little too full or something, and so I won, and she stayed with me. But she has been a fine clarinetist, just a rock-solid contributor, bandsman, in my program, as she was for Mrs. Johnson in her program. I just got to win on that one. Maritza may take a gap year this year to work, and then she plans to go to Clark College for at least a couple years and hopefully transfer to a four-year institution. Okay. Her favorite memories from band are definitely the parades, and she's talking a lot. When she says the parades, that means Starlight Parade, that means the Festival of Roses, that means Loyalty Days Parade several years, and the parades down at the fort too. So, yeah, she's done a lot with us. She'll miss most playing together with everyone as a group, which is like one of the great experiences that all of us get, whether it's choir, orchestra, it's just playing with other people and making this great thing happen. So I agree with you, Maritza. Some advice she'd like to give to freshmen coming into band next year, it's really all about the rhythm, yeah. The notes can come later. Also, this is a small band, so I suggest to play out until Mr. Norris tells you to shut up. This is speaking from experience, so. Okay, Justin came to me as a sixth grader back at McLaughlin Middle School. He's been with me for 7 years now. And Justin, if I was gonna pick someone who I would say most improved musician, I would say Justin is the man. Justin, when he first started with me at Mac, was very remote and spent a lot of time just doing his own thing in the band, and he always contributed, but he did his own thing. And you know, we just kept going. He kept coming back year after year, and each year he was dealing with other stuff more. This year, he runs the trombone section. He's taking solos with the band. He's just such a leader in the band. I hate to see him go, you know. I hate to get like, oh, you did this all at the last minute, but he's really gone so far. I have every expectation that he's gonna be successful in life. He plans to get a job at Sky Zone, and then he wants to move into some sort of electrical trade. His favorite memory of band is also going to the John Williams concerts with the Oregon Symphony. What he'll miss most about being in band is the pep basketball games. And his advice to incoming freshmen is for them to pick trombone, especially if you're a trombone player. It's a little late otherwise if you're a flute player. So Mr. Justin Bollinger, I also want to say that Fort Vancouver, the United States Armed Forces award a special award to a unique bandsman each year. And this year that award goes to Mr. Justin Bollinger. So Gavin, I didn't arrange these guys this way, but they just keep getting longer. Gavin Alanis, you saw him playing drums, you saw him playing bass earlier with the orchestra. Gavin Alanis, he started with me in the fifth grade in morning program, the first year of our morning fifth grade program. And I don't know if you're still here, but Gavin was in the fifth grade band on trombone, but on trumpet, is Aaron Narvasa still here? Okay, so those of you choir people that are still here, Aaron Narvasa was in Gavin's band in the fifth grade. She was great too. Gavin went from trombone in the fifth grade to trumpet in the sixth grade. He stayed with, sixth grade was trombone, seventh grade was trumpet. By the end of the seventh grade year, he was playing the drum, and that's where he was going on along. And then from then on, he stayed in percussion, and he stayed with me in percussion since then. He's done so much for our pep band and for the concert band as well. Because of his drum set playing and because of his creativity, he's just lit up the program. It's so much fun. People enjoy our band at the basketball game so much. He plans on working at the hospital with his father, and he might want to go to community college sometime next year. Back in the seventh grade, his favorite experience, back in the seventh grade, when I was wearing a giant bass drum and I noticed a wasp coming towards me, so I ran to the door and Norris yelled at me. Notice this refrain, the yelling. And Norris yelled at me, setting up massive drum. Well, that's a different thing there. So his favorite memory is me yelling at him, that's as good as it gets for poor Gavin, I'm afraid. That's his favorite. What he'll miss most about band is setting up massive drum sets every year. It's not what I will miss about band, but it's what he likes to take two or three drum sets and combine them into a giant drum castle and then play them when I'm not around. And his advice to freshmen is practice, practice, practice. This is probably no surprise to anyone on stage or any of the other musicians in the room here tonight. You saw Gavin playing with the choir. You saw Gavin playing drums with the orchestra and also playing bass with the orchestra. He also played bass guitar with our mariachi that we had before the pandemic. He's been such a versatile musician and he's been such a contributor to my program. It's no surprise that Gavin is also the recipient by unanimous vote of the arts faculty of the Performing Artist of the Year. One more round of applause for them all, please. Okay, I just want to say to all the people that are sitting in the back, be like them. Be like them, okay? Awesome. Go sit down. We got one more for you. So now I have to move to this mic. We did kind of modern jazz, a Latin jazz thing, and then we did something from World War II from the swing era when everyone was dancing the jitterbug or Lindy Hop. This last song we're going to do, it goes back even further to the era of the gangsters, Prohibition in 1920s Chicago. Chicago was one of the most exciting places. All these people came up from New Orleans and from the South looking for work, and they infused the popular music in the big city full of jazz. And so the city was all about jazz, and it was a different style. It was more like tap dance oriented and show reviews. The medley we're going to play is from a Broadway musical written by John Kander and Fred Ebb entitled Chicago, that for all I know, it's actually touring again. It's spectacular music, spectacular music. That's all I can say. Candor and Ab wrote, if you remember, Cabaret. They wrote that spectacular musical. And they are also the guys that wrote the music for a film called New York, New York, which featured the title song that Frank Sinatra made famous. You know, These Little Town Blues. Candor and Ab wrote that one. So without talking anymore, here's our last medley. This is from the Broadway musical Chicago, featuring the tunes All That Jazz, Cell Block Tango, Roxy, and my favorite title, She Had It Coming.
We'll be right back.
Andrew Banshew on trumpet, Justin Bollinger on trombone, Tegan Wells on tenor sax, some solos that were featured. Okay. And a special thanks, our man on tuba, Kevin Juarez. Yay. Has come back to help us up one last time. Thank you so much for all of your, thank you for coming. Thank you for staying. And this is our last concert of the year, unless you go to commencement to see our graduates go off. So I just eternally am grateful to all the support that you all bring to our program. And thank you to your, for your support that you've given to your students. Have a good evening. Good night.